Welcome back to Let's Play Diablo 3. It's technically called the Ultimate Eva Edition, not Reaper of Souls. Kairi's Adventure, Hardcore Mode. I turned up the difficulty again, because isn't the joy of trying it in this mode the concept that I might die at any moment, and then we're over, we're done? I mean, yeah, I have the Templar who has the capacity to heal, so, you know, it's made easier, slightly. And yes, I can only get it to expert mode right now, and we can't increase it until after we've beaten the game, basically, so that sucks. But, yeah, we should do it this way, because doing it any other way is just not fun. And it also makes me think every time I get hit, I need to run. Despite the fact that I know I shouldn't. Ah, get out of here. So, you'll see that between this part and the last part, yes, my levels have gone up quite a bit. Because I did a little bit of off-screen grinding, as I said I would. Mirror of the Burr, that's for someone else, yeah. Someone I don't even have yet. Because there's more than one follower. Although you can only have one at a time, so that's a little bit lackluster. We're using hammers to supplement our thing. I found a second monster hunter, so currently our Templar friend is wearing it.
Patience.
Let's horse our way through. There's nothing on there. Oh, hang on. I think I did pick up some other books. I can't remember what books I picked up though. Like the villager's journal.
Gone mad.
Oh, you have to stay on that page. I guess we'll, if I find them, it's because I found them during a prior quest. They were stuff that we'd missed. So I won't leave them. I'll be quiet when we find them, but there's no point in leaving them on normally, because I mean, we don't get much in the way of needing them. And I'm sure they're online on a resource if you want to hear them, rather than take up time in the times I could be putting my character's life in danger. Normal guys are easier to kill because we've got legendary weapons. We'll get rare weapons that outclass our regular weapons in time.
Patience. Well,
for now, legendary is the way we're going to do. Templar bro is just going to be a bro to us.
Not
I love lawful
yet.
Stupid.
My wrath is low.
Which is what everyone is currently. My wrath is low. Falling Sword is useful against these guys. It doesn't seem to be super good against elite. Which is good, bad, I don't know. It's the at least. Get out of here, skellies. I've got hammers. And I know that hammers affect you quite a lot. Or at least I hope they would. Who are you talking to, Crusader? They are dead. Ruin all your stuff. Get dimensional speed so we can move faster. Keep our charging steed so we can move even faster still. I didn't think that would hit them. I'm pleasantly surprised.
Not ready yet.
It's not ready yet. I tampered with the sound settings a little bit, so you should be able to hear the conversations, because they seemed a bit quiet. Not 100% sure if they were, but they felt quiet.
Not yet.
I shouldn't have hit that wall. Ruined my entire plan.
Not ready yet.
I severely underestimated blessed hammers, because they are great. the better the way they are currently. Obviously, you know, spinning around us.
Patience.
Could have jumped into the middle of them, Kyrie, instead of jumping to the side and just hitting one dude. Oops. Oh well. You have infinite potions. In an earlier version of this game, you actually had to find potions. So you had a limited supply, which, well, it didn't suck, because I rarely used them, but I feel the fact that you've got them on cooldown. A large fawn shield. It's more armor, bigger block chance as well. Don't. Get off the wall. Not a lectern.
Patience.
They do give you a lot of lecterns. Usually, so you don't need to find every single one to get books, and then they just give you gold when you find them. Which I'm also okay with.
Not ready yet.
And if you're playing as a different character, you can pick them up entirely again. I thought they'd be a crossover thing, but because they've given them the ability to grant experience, I guess it makes a lot of sense. Karen bats, the bats that Karens. Bad luck for you, friend. Yeah, another level up. What do we get from this one? The Flea Rune from Flea Fool from Provoke. Law of Justice gets protect the innocent. I don't know what that one does. Law of Justice, protect the innocent. Also reflects some of the damage taken by your allies. Empowering Law also increases your life on hit. I think that is more useful to us. Consecration Rune. Bathe in the light. So consecration is our healing skill, which we could actually put on. What does it do? Oh, where are we? Consecration. You and guys heal for greater amounts. That's actually helpful. Dealing your fawn damage every second. Wow, if we do fawns, we're going to put bed of nails on. But let's put falling sword back on for now. Where are you? There you are. Yes. Yes. Hammers don't fly directly at you, but they'll get to you eventually. Smash all the books in the room. Horse really speeds things up, but probably isn't essential to our build. It was essential to begin with, kind of, because it stopped us from dying, mostly. We don't want to die, really, because then we have to come back. Then we have to level up a whole different character, but that is the point of hardcore mode. And that's why we're doing this version, because I need to get to level 70 with a hardcore character, so you might as well witness me doing it, because otherwise I'd have music on in the background or listening to a podcast. Because there's a certain level of monotony. I mean, you hear the in-game sounds and music, and once you've heard the story once, you've probably got the gist of it. I mean, I do enjoy the way the Crusader yells at people.
I require more wrath.
Yells at them to bathe in the light, praise Zakaroon. I will take that, double our damage. Well, the problem is, I need to get down these stairs to hit these guys. Get out of here. What is the harvester harvesting imps? That's weird. They used to be full of eels. Eels up inside here. Out of my way, please. I need you dead. There we go.
Not ready yet.
Oh, the door is there. Excellent.
Burn
in the light.
Patience.
Right. So, knowing that that area connects to that area, we're going to go explore just that upper corner, because we know that this lower corner has our actual goal. I do find it weird that the goal only appears when you get somewhat close, but it doesn't appear even if. And we've already done this chapter too slow. And I have since started a new half of it, because if you can beat Act 1 in under an hour, you get
not ready yet.
A challenge completed for it. At least, that's what I saw. But I think we're way behind on that, considering how many parts in we are. Also, Act 1 seems to be the longest of all the acts. The other acts are much shorter. Act 4 is very short. Let's go over here and explore the top area. We didn't go up here, and it's full of Karen bats. Soon it won't be full of Karen bats.
Patience.
Wow, okay, there's a whole area we didn't explore up here. I'll get back and kill those bats when they follow me. Yeah, whole area, wow. Although these bookshelves are already ruined. I didn't ruin them. At least I don't think I did, and there's gold behind me that I haven't picked up.
Not ready yet.
Get here. I've got gold. I'm probably not... Well, I am using it to upgrade our merchant fellows. I know there's such people.
Make your peace quickly.
Can skeletons make peace? Like, think about it. Are they sentient or controlled?
Not yet.
And I was about to say Blizzards of the Coast then. That doesn't make any sense. Wizards? Wizards? It's Blizzard. Jeez. Get him a magic and my... I think you're confused.
Patience.
Blizzard have announced the Necromancer class. We've yet to run into the fellow, but he's been in the game. And now they're like, yeah, he's actually going to be a playable class. And we'll bring in seasons to consoles, so...
Not yet.
I could even play a seasonal character and gain some different transmogs and pets and stuff. Currently there's an event going on, but I'm not at the stage to do it because still haven't beaten the game because my two gaming partners, we have yet to get to the end of it. One I just haven't played with in about 2 weeks because it was Christmas. The other one, well, they're working. And we play actual D&D on certain days, so we can't keep playing this while also trying to meet up and play that. Ooh, there's a goblin. I'm gonna hurt myself, get in trouble because of this. Yes, I am. Hang on. That helps. Getting double damage really helps me. I was so busy focusing on that treasure goblin, I didn't even see everything else die. These just working your magic, you stupid spinning things. Keep going. Save everything that I need. Go. Go, my spinning axes. I know the hammers. It's called Blessed Hammer. That is the actual name of the move. Go, destroy all things. How high a kill count can we get? Where's the 100? Nice. We will level up as soon as this thing ends. We level up.
Patience.
We got a times 3 multiplier, so... Can't be any more. Staggering shield. Another new rune. Super heated. Super heated. Wow, it was so busy telling me everything else, it wasn't showing me the scenes for those talking. For Templar talking to me.
Not
oh well. So... Falling Sword needs that rune on. I was planning on putting the Lore Hope on it, just not there. The ground you fall on becomes super heated.
damaging enemies who pass on it, or, you know, damaging them as they're there. Lore of Hope shields you and provides continual healing. Very useful when we don't want to die. It's part of the reason I also picked the Crusader, because it's one of the tankier and less killable classes. I've died with it once during my time when I just got... When there was a treasure goblin like last time, I ran to it, but I had Blessed Shield on instead. Or Shield Bash Eden. Let's check what that other thing does. Oh, Blessed Shield. You throw the shield, and then enemies hit by it can be stunned, but... We're taking Thunderstruck, because Thunderstruck's just better. No longer taunts, instead causes fear. Yep, we knew that. But we don't want that. No, no, no. We want other abilities. Yes, yes, yes.
Not yet.
Horse-based abilities. Hmm. We need to cover this section, and then we'll head back. I wish I could up my movement speed for you. I could fast forward bits where I'm just dead walking, but
not ready
it allows me to have conversations with you. I'd realise this area is much bigger than I anticipated initially. Again, keep doing that. Should stop underestimating this area. It's large. It's a big... under the cathedral. Although I wonder who made half this stuff. I mean, it looks very similar to other places. Which makes you think... I know that they randomly spawn more, but it makes you think, like, in-game, who decided that this was a good way to build things?
The Crusaders swore an oath to dedicate their lives to the search. None believed that they would be the one to end the Crusade by finding and cleansing the corruption. They believed the search ennobled them, that the discipline of their life and journey was the true goal. The Crusader was meant to find meaning in the quest itself.
The Crusader crusades, and that's what makes them a Crusader. That is basically what that guy just said. It's weird. Well, there was an imp there. Get in.
Not yet.
Not yet. Do 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 do. Running round as a hot horse. We nearly hit level 25. I'm about halfway to 25.
Not ready yet.
Not ready yet. Come on, horse. Ghost horse. Spirit horse. Horse that I need. Horse that holds the woods together. Horse.
Patience.
I know backtracking is tedious, but if you think about it, we gained a lot of experience from doing that, because we went to a room where there were about 100 dudes that we just straight killed, all of them. And we killed a treasure goblin for some form of reward, at least. Actually, it was this. Which doesn't have strength, but has vite, has experience per hit, but I think we'll keep. Because of the attacks... Ooh... That's actually... tempting. It's very tempting. What level is it? Oh, I shouldn't have junked it. Oh well, junk everything else. Level 19, so it's similar. I think we'll keep the Monster Hunter for now. I'm just insisting upon the Monster Hunter for now, I think. Down to the Royal Crypts. I think this place is the same every time you spawn into it, which is, it'll have these ashes. It's got lots of ash urns. This is actually, if you're trying to get trophies and challenges, this is the best place to do the, smash so many pots, because there's tons of pots.
I require more wrath.
Like, oodles of pots. I think the urns that possibly contain people's ashes and we're terrible people.
We have just arrived in Tristram, and I must say, I'm a bit dismayed. This place is a backwater filled with serfs and an ancient broken down monastery, hardly fit for the King of Condorus. I cannot fathom why Lazarus was so intent on this becoming our new seat of power.
Well, if we know any Hink, it's because of other Hinks. It's King Leodric's sword.
Keep your distance from him. This burden is mine to bear. May death bring peace from your madness, Leoric.
Traitors! Even in death, the armies of Condorus will still obey their king, even if you will not.
Not ready yet.
Showing his, the guy's journals that I think we've been reading, one of them at least, murdering the king, because the king's gone bonkers. Because I think the reason Lazarus wants them to make that Hing is because Lazarus serves Lord Diablo. Apparently Tristram lies on a fault line, maybe? I don't know. Alright, Leodric.
You dare to bring the warmth of life into my tomb?
Yes.
We shall put you down, Hellspawn!
Then they trigger the activated pillars, which we need to deactivate to stop the undead rising, I think. Feels that way. Get out of here, undead. We don't need you.
Not yet.
Not yet.
My wrath is low.
It's a good job we regenerate wrath so quickly. Could even set it to even higher using the Templar's additional abilities. But we don't need to do that. It is also weird that the abilities of the Templar cap at level 20. Like, they gain one for each 5 levels, it seems. But you're usually a high enough level to have most of them unlocked by the time you're even here. Patience. Which means every time you meet all the other assistants, they're just like, yeah, I got all my abilities. Now, the thing with the Crusader is, I believe, Crusader, Templar, I think they use strength as the main attack, which means as a Crusader I get shields that give strength and vight, so they're good to pass along to him. But like the other ones embody the different traits, so the intelligence and the dexterity. But if I were to try and give the dex one a dex shield, I'm probably not going to find many shields like that, because with the smart loot system, which is in place, I should get things that are relevant to my character rather than just any old things. It was an introduction by Blizzard, and it was very good.
A fetid, pallid malaise has fallen over the manor we now call home. Young Albrecht seems to be enjoying himself in our new home, however. Perhaps I am simply suffering from an imbalance of humors brought on by the recent change of clan.
Hmm.
Before the battle and after.
You could admit that so simply.
I don't understand that conversation piece.
Not enough wrath.
I get that people wouldn't, like, admit to being scared, but she admits to being scared first and last, but not patience when it's happening. Which doesn't seem like a simple feat, honestly. It seems complicated. Get out of here, skeletons. We don't need you. I never need you.
Not ready yet.
Very close to King Leodric now. He's just downstairs. Raw ruin is phenomenal. The more block presents you have, the better it gets. Which is why on a different character I have a 75% block chance, because it's incredible. There's a certain level of crazy that character has got because of items.
Crypt of the Skeleton King.
You will never defeat me!
Haven't you been defeated like twice, at least once?
You were defeated the moment you surrendered to madness.
Alright, calm down, friend. My job to be the crazy zealot one.
The Returned.
It says Returned, not The Returned. No, it says kill the Returned on the top. Get blinded. Not that I need to do it, but, you know, get blinded anyway. Makes me feel better.
Oh.
Place the crown on the king's head. I'm literally here to help you. Apparently. Let me place my crown on your head. Here you go. Because apparently the crown makes you a king. This isn't good. Nope, not good at all. You immune to being stunned? Blinded even? Oh well, let me consecrate the ground you're on. He seems to be doing less damage than I'm used to. You can summon all the skeletons you want. I'll probably kill more of them and then get double damage from it. Because I'm still attacking you. Yeah, okay, he can be blinded. I guess. Just not doing that much damage, so. It's just a. Ah! Okay, that did tons. Did a lot more than I anticipated just then. Should probably try and avoid that move instead. Be wise. Wise ability to just avoid it. Yeah. Ow.
Patience.
Next time he tries to do it, maybe we should try and do the block technique. Which is, I use my circle and just absorb damage from it. What are you doing, Leodric? Please stop. Don't make me blind you. Let's just use crowd control abilities. What is he? He's the Mad King of Tristram. The Skeletal King. The Mad King of Tristram. When he does the full whirlwind attack, that's what does the most damage. Yee. Didn't think he'd be this strong, honestly. I mean, I knew it'd be strong, and I know my defense isn't at its best, but I forget what powerful abilities he has. Can't do that just yet. Do whatever. Eh. Get some damage over time on him. Get these hammers out. Oh, another double damage. Excellent. That'll speed things up slightly. By like 2%. Not very quick, but you know. One at a time. Bit by bit. We'll get him done. Please die. Please don't kill me, and please die. Those are the words I need. Yeah. Yeah. This feels like a boss. I don't have enough Rapid Falling Sword. No! Ah, the shield absorbs damage, so therefore I don't take any. Good, good. I really kind of want to keep this kill combo going. Which requires him to not leave next to me. I have never really used my defensive abilities fully, so this is really good for me. Hit him. Oh, we lost the combo. No. Oh, we leveled up. It's nice. Legendary helmet that's King Leodric's. You learn Acherax Champion. You learned Frozen in Terror. You learned Indestructible. So we should have another version of King Leodric's crown right now. That's a lot of strength. That's a lot of vite. Do I have any gems? I've got a ruby, which gives us bonus experience. Let's put that in the crown. So now, we are gaining experience at an increased rate. 18% bonus experience. Seems good. Yes, we will take that. It's just strictly better. Doesn't give life per second, so we'll forget about that one. More armor, but not a huge amount. Memoirs of the Dead just seems better. Check our friend. The Shattered Wedge is even better for him. So Akarat's champion basically makes us huge. I'll show that off later. Frozen gives you a chance to stun all enemies nearby, but we want the healing, basically. Horse Charge, engulf in righteous fire, scorching those who cross its path. Seems helpful. And Indestructible. When you receive fatal damage, you instead become immune to damage, gain increased 30% damage, and gain a lot of life per... Ooh. So when you should die, you don't die. That might be useful to put on to save us having the misery. When we get our level 30 slot, I think I might have to put that one in. And then we don't have to worry as much about dying immediately. Let's go downstairs anyway. King Leodric will always drop his crown. It's a guaranteed drop. And because legendary scale, whatever level you kill it, you always want to kill him as whatever level you can.
Not ready yet.
So if you get a level 70 character and you haven't played the campaign, then it's very good to do it then. Hello, stranger. The
falling star was a man.
Interesting.
I am. I remember falling.
Through several floors, at least.
I am not your enemy. I think. Yes, I believe I have come with a warning. The darkness. The darkness is coming. I must... I don't remember.
Be calm and come with me.
Come with me to Tristram. There is a portal here. He will go through the portal. More plot.
The fallen star was a man. Only a man. I begin to wonder if his fall is related to my crusade. I will take him to the old scholar. He may know.
Deckard Cain knows a lot. And we'll set ourselves on our next quest. Hey, Cain.
Meet the falling star.
No man could survive such a thing. Who are you? What are you?
A warrior, I think. I came bearing grave news, but I cannot remember.
Your message might be all that can save us from impending doom.
Ooh, the Null Titan. You got nothing in there. Can I train you a bit more? Just a little bit more. Prepare, I think. Let's do some management once we've got our next quest. Or do we do that? No, we do that in the next part. I'm going to do some order management. Kairi will survive for another day. And I'll see you then.